What's up, sisterhood? It is Kristen and Bethany here, and we're gonna be talking about crazy girl emotions. I don't know about you. There have been a few tears that have come from these eyes. Yours too.
Yeah.
Emotions are hard, and we can feel like crazy girls. We talk about that, like, where you just feel like ups and downs.
Oh, yeah.
So how do you have a stable life and embrace emotions in the right way? We're going to talk about that, but first,
I want to share with you a few things. So y'all know that our Patreon family is the lifeblood of this channel. Thank you so much. Our Patreon family
y'all
is just
awesome.
Basically a group of y'all who support every video with like $1, $2, and for our thanks to you, a small bit of thanks, we offer you a free product every single month. Some of the ones we've offered you in the past is a guide battling sexual temptation, a biblical toolkit for Christian girls. Mm. Another one that we offered is the Christian Girls Breakup Survival Guide. We've offered other ones, a Proverbs 31-day devotional. 31 days through Proverbs.
31 days through Proverbs.
A devotional. Fear.
Fighting Fear and Worry prayer journal. That was our newest one that just came out.
Yeah, there's all others. And basically, you, when you become a patron, when you join our family, you get access to every single free product that we've, you know, privately given to our patrons. And then the next month, you get our new free product. So if you're like, that sounds like a steal, and I'd love to support you, you can click the link below, patreon.com/girldefined, to join.
Get all the details. Okay, let's talk about emotions, because that's something every single one of us as humans, but then I feel like as girls, you know, we maybe handle our emotions a little bit differently than guys. I know I cry a lot more than my husband, Zach. I don't know, maybe yours.
Just like
different.
The experience. Oh, yeah. Dave and I were kind of funny. He's like on the more emotional side, and I'm like a little bit. I feel like there are guys who cry, and then there are guys who are like, I've never seen him cry, you know?
Yeah.
So Dave cries.
It's okay. Yeah. Crying's fine. It's not a problem. And when we talk about emotions, the reason we want to talk about this is because I know in my life there have been times where I felt out of control.
Yeah.
Like, how do I control these emotions? How do I get myself, like, how do I pull it together and just, like, process this in, like, a normal, healthy way, like a biblical way? And so thinking about that, I think it's something so many of us wrestle with.
Okay,
you
I'm thinking
story.
Of something.
Yes.
I'm thinking of something that actually involves both of us. And this, I'm just going to make this quick because it is just hilarious. So we have some crazy emotions. And emotions can be a beautiful thing. But there was a time when, years and years ago, I don't even know, we were in high school.
Young.
No,
oh,
I don't
had
know.
To be younger.
Younger, teens somewhere. And we got home and we're very sensitive, like animals and bugs, and we don't want them to get hurt except if it's a roach, smash it, but anything else besides that. So we saw these two big snails outside of our car on the grass, and we were like, oh, the snails, like, we don't want them to get crunched by someone, but we're like, it's late. Oh, well, you know, they'll be fine. So we go inside, and a few minutes later, our dad walks out to get something out of the car, and we're chasing after him, and we're like, dad, don't smash the snails. And it's like raining and it's dark, and he's like, what are my
We're literally yelling,
Dad, the snails!
Don't smash the snails! He's like, what are y'all even talking about?
And so he's like looking back, and as he's looking back and walking, we literally hear crunch and then crunch. Both snails that we specifically saw and didn't want to get crunched, both were now gone. And we lost it. We literally burst into tears. Our tears were bigger than the raindrops. They were flooding our driveway because we felt so bad. We were like, if we had moved the snails, then they would still be alive. They were probably a happy family. I mean, it sounds ridiculous, but this literally happened. So that's just an extreme,
extreme reaction, an emotional reaction, out of proportionate reaction. Like,
maybe
not proportionate for the situation. Yes. Snail, we love snails, we love God's creatures, but really, so thinking about emotions, we can have overreactions, and, you know, I think we need to rewind, though, and just think biblically, like, okay, are emotions all bad? Are they all good? Like, how do we think about emotions? And when we see in the very beginning of Genesis, God, he created humans with emotions. He made us in his likeness, in his image, and so that tells us that, well, yeah, God has emotions, but he's perfect, and we see God express emotions at different points in scripture, so God is an emotional God. He cares, he feels. And I think that's the good, the beautiful side of emotions, is that emotions really allow us to connect deeply relationally. Yeah. I mean, to be happy and joyful, someone says something funny and we laugh. Like,
yes,
there's emotions on display. So there's so many beautiful ways we express emotions. But then we hit Genesis 3, right, where sin enters the world. And for the first time ever, you think Adam and Eve, they felt for the first time emotions of fear. They hid from God. They were afraid. They felt like rejected from one another. They were deceived. They, you know, felt angry. They felt worried. Now what's going to happen to our future? So the first time we see sin, like emotions that have been impacted by sin. And so when we're talking about emotions today, I think we want to make that distinction that there's beautiful right ways to express emotions, but then our emotions have also been impacted by sin, mm-hmm. and our emotions can feel so strong that they can lead yeah. us and drive us to do things and drive us to react in certain ways. And I think we need to kind of get to the root of, okay, why are we acting that way? What's going on in our hearts?
Yeah, well, and we're all so different with our emotions yeah. too. Like
the way we express them. I think that's
the
thing,
the way we express them. And you may be like, well, I'm not going to burst out in tears over the snail, but maybe you internally are struggling emotionally. So I think it's important for us to recognize, like, how do you handle your emotions? Do you clam up? Yeah. Do you, like, lots of clams and snails examples. Do you clam up or do you keep it internal? Do you not let anyone know yeah. how you're feeling or what you're thinking? Or are you, it's out there for everyone. I would say you were a little bit more out there for everyone. Everyone knew, you know, what you were yeah. thinking. You know, it's like, you just wore it. And I was there. A little bit more internal, like, okay, I might just deal with it yeah. by myself. But, you know, we have to learn how to handle each of those biblically. So what do you think is the first step
yeah.
to handling emotions?
You know, I think the biggest thing, there's so much we could talk about, yeah. but the biggest thing that has helped me, and I know we've talked about this, is there was a time in my life early in my marriage where I just felt like, I've got to get control of my emotions. Like, I'm just getting, you know, offended by the littlest things. Yeah. I'm crying at the smallest conflict. Like, what is wrong with me? And so I was really praying, God, help me to control my emotions. Give me control over my emotions. And I wasn't really seeing a lot of breakthroughs
yeah.
for a few weeks. And then I went to this Christian conference. And of course, I attended one of the sessions on emotions. Like, I need that. And the speaker said something that really, I mean, it has stuck with me to this day. But they were saying that our emotions are directly fueled by what we're thinking about. Mm. And so it's not so much that we're trying to control our emotions. The true way that we help our emotions is by really controlling our thinking. That's thinking good. About what I'm thinking about, because what we think about fuels how we feel. It's like yeah. the steering wheel for our feelings. And so if you're like, yeah, why did I react that way? Someone said something and I just lashed out. What was going on there? Well, if you rewind and go, yeah. well, what was I thinking about? How did I process that? That's what ultimately led you to feel the way you feel yeah. and then to act the way you act.
Yeah. I mean, as an example of that would be, I think of in high school when we would get curfews, you know, like we would have a curfew like during the week.
Hated those curfews. Nights.
It was like, okay, you need to be home by this time so that you can get to bed and get up mm-hmm. and do school. Very reasonable. Yeah. But we didn't love the curfews. And so we would get on this thinking pattern of thinking like, oh, mom and dad, they just don't want us to have fun. Mm-hmm. They're just so strict. Those other people, they can stay out an hour later. Like, why do we? So we would allow our thoughts to go down like a sinful, disrespectful pattern mm-hmm. and a thought process. And then we would feel upset, angry, annoyed at our parents.
Resentful.
And it wasn't resentful. It yeah. wasn't just that we automatically felt that way. It started with our thoughts and then resulted in that action yeah. and in that emotion.
Yeah.
But if you rewind, it's like, oh, that's why we felt mm-hmm. upset, because we didn't take our thoughts captive. Yeah. We didn't, you know, pray in that moment or say, God, no, let me stop and think. Thank you for my parents. Thank you that they came. Thank you that they're putting this, you know, curfew up to help me. We did the opposite.
Right.
But if we had done the yeah. other, we would have had a positive emotion yes. and been like, wow, I'm so grateful for my parents. But we didn't yeah. because we yeah. didn't really handle
you know,
it
really. I've heard it said, like, our circumstances don't dictate the way we feel. It's how we think about yeah. our circumstances that impact the way we feel. And so if you really pause and think, what am I thinking about? Or I think a huge one for us as girls is things that people say to us or things that we read that aren't true. They're lies or maybe they're partial truths. And then we think about that. I mean, how many times have you laid yeah. in bed at night, right? Looking at the ceiling, you can't fall asleep. We were just talking about yeah. this. Your brain's going. That's called meditation. That's thinking over and over about something. And it's in those moments that I think the verse that has helped me the most, and we've talked about this, is Philippians 4:8, which talks about whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, just, commendable, think about these things. And the yeah. Bible talks so much about our thoughts, yeah. about our minds. Take every thought captive to the obedience of Christ. Think about these things. Meditate on what is true, on what is right. And really, that's where the answer lies. Yeah. And as I started applying God's truth to my heart by asking God to help me to take my thoughts captive, to think about what was true and what was right in those moments, in that moment where I yeah. want to respond emotionally and just, blah, you know, however I'm feeling, just allow my feelings to lead me, really rewinding and say, God, help me to filter what I'm thinking through the lens of your word.
Yeah.
And then as I filter what I'm thinking through the lens of your word, and in that moment when I'm feeling it and I stop and say, God, help me in this moment, please help me to control my thinking, then that's when I saw change yeah, in my actions.
For sure.
And I think for each one of us, that's the key.
I think that's what we want you to take home, is that specific passage of scripture, Philippians 4, mm-hmm. 8, and 9. We want you to go look it up in your own Bible or look it up online if you don't have a Bible, and just ask yourself, do I use this? Like, have I ever used this as kind of like a filter to filter my thoughts through, or do mm-hmm. I just let them run wild? And we would really love for you to print this verse up or memorize it. And when you are hit with a situation where you're like, okay, I'm getting a curfew, mm-hmm. or this hard thing happened, I have a choice right yeah. now. what am I going to think about? And then pull that verse up and say, okay, here's my list of what God says I should be thinking about.
Yeah.
Also Psalm 51:10 is a great like short prayer to pray in those moments where you're struggling and you're like, I don't want to think about something that I'm not supposed to. I just need to recite something. You could recite Psalm 51:10, which says, create in me a pure heart, O God, and renew a steadfast, which is what we need, spirit within me. So two passages you can go check out. We would love to hear from you though. Have you ever had a situation where you just felt out of control emotionally or had an overreaction to something or just felt something like so deeply, or maybe it was a good emotion and you're like, I loved feeling that way. That was wonderful. I loved the joy I felt for that person. We would love to hear those stories, and then comment letting us know what you think about Philippians 4:8-9 and how you could apply that verse.
Yeah. So come hang out with us over on Instagram. That's where we're going to be commenting and hanging out with y'all. So go to Instagram @RealDefined. We will see y'all over there.